Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today, since February is the Valentine's season, I thought I would give a list of 14 things you can do on Valentine's Day. I sat down and I thought about these over a couple days to figure out the best ones for you guys and the most girly aesthetic ones, because that's really important to me, and so I think it would be important to you guys too. Also, if I sound sick, I think I'm getting allergies, so my nose is kind of stuffy, so please forgive me. 4 things to do on Valentine's Day. Most of these are alone for, like, if you're single like me, because we don't need a guy or a girl to enjoy Valentine's Day. Number one, put on makeup just because. Now, I love just putting on makeup even when I'm just gonna be sitting at home doing school. It's just so much fun, and it just makes me, like, feel ready for the day, even if I don't even do a lot, even if it's just like concealer, blush, highlighter, and mascara. Like, I'm fine because I feel ready, you know? Number two, read a romance book. Now, I haven't read many romance books just because I'm not a huge reader, but I think reading a romance book will give you enough romance for the day. And it's very Valentine's themed, so it just has to go for Valentine's Day. Number three, have a party with your single friends. Now, you can have a party with your friends that may be dating somebody, but I think it would be more fun to do it with single girls, because I think this is just so much more fun, because you can just be girls without having to worry about boys or anything, which is a really fun idea. Number four, eat an entire box of chocolate. Now that I've paused this on a very weird spot, I thought I would let you guys know this is not aimed to offend anybody. I just really enjoy chocolate, so eating an entire box of chocolate sounds super fun to me and super delicious. Not the healthiest thing ever, but I really love chocolate, so I added this in just for all those chocolate lovers out there. So please, this is not supposed to offend anybody at all. I love you guys. Now, you may not be able to do this because you can't have a lot of sugar. I mean, and this isn't the healthiest thing to do, but if you're sad, chocolate. I'm not gonna put that in, but yeah, chocolate. I love chocolate. I literally could eat an entire large heart box of chocolates on Valentine's Day. Our family tradition is our dad goes out on Saturday morning, the day after Valentine's Day, and gets the cheap stuff because we don't want him to spend a bunch of money on chocolates just for it to be on that day. I think Saturday is the best day because it's Singles Appreciation Day. So, this year it's on a Saturday. That's why I was saying Saturday. It's not always on a Saturday. I'm gonna stop talking. I'm weird. Number five, watch a cute rom-com. Mainly Hallmark, because Hallmark has the best rom-coms ever, especially during Christmas. I haven't watched many other Valentine's Day rom-coms, but rom-coms are, like, the best Hallmark movies ever. Number six, take cute Instagram pictures. Now, you can do this with friends or without friends. I think it would be helpful to at least have a sibling with you so that they can get the right angle and make sure that they know how to, like, take good pictures and that kind of thing. But if it's with friends, they can take some cute pictures of you, and you can get, like, your parent or your sibling to take pictures of group pictures, and that's just really cute and really fun. Number seven. Now, I don't know if I created this or not. I haven't seen this anywhere. I was like, hey, this would be really fun. And it was in the middle of the night, so I could have seen it somewhere. I don't know. But if you've seen this somewhere, please let me know. But number seven is write a self-love letter for yourself and open it on next Valentine's Day. So basically, this is like writing a love letter. I was thinking, hey, you could write love letters. I was like, but it's Valentine's Day, and if you're single, you don't need to write a love letter. Like, you don't have to. So I was thinking, how could I incorporate that? Because it's a really cute thing. It's like, what about a self-love letter? A love letter to yourself. You can write about what you love about yourself, your favorite things about yourself, what you love about how you've grown and matured. I wrote, be honest. Now, this is very important. I think it's good, like, if you're insecure about something, I think it would be good for you to say that you are but then list a few reasons why you love that you're that way. So for example, I am a very short person, as some of you guys know, and I don't really like being short. Like, it's just not something that I really enjoy all that much. But some things that I do love is that taking pictures in a group, I'm either in the front or laying on somebody's lap if we're sitting down, or being carried by somebody. And it's just super easy because as a small person, I'm just naturally light, so I can just be picked up and carried everywhere. And it's just really fun. And another one, this is kind of Valentine's Day themed, it hasn't seemed to have worked yet, but people have told me that when you are a short person, that guys feel like they can protect you so that they like you. But so far that hasn't worked, probably because I look like I'm 9. But you know what? Hey, that makes me win at carnivals when they try to guess your name. Just a little rant. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Okay. And then when you open it on the next Valentine's Day, you get to see how much you've grown, and you get to be reminded of the things that you really enjoy about yourself. Number 8, go to the mall and buy something for yourself. Now, this could be a Bath & Body Works candle or a scent, or it could be some comfy clothes so that you can lay and eat that box of chocolates in, like pink sweatpants or a pink hoodie or that kind of thing. I really like going to the mall. My mall isn't the best, but it does have some good stores like Pink and Pandora and Bath & Body Works and the important stuff like Chick-fil-A. Number 9, have a daddy-daughter date. Now, I really, really enjoy going on dates with my dad because it's just really fun and it's a great way for us to get to know each other more. And I really enjoy spending time with my dad. So I keep saying really a lot, but I had to put this in because it's a very important thing to have a good relationship with your parents. A daddy-daughter date is a really good idea, and since it's Valentine's Day, especially if you're single, this is the best thing ever. I always tell my dad that he's the only guy I'll ever need. I know one day I'll get married, but right now, that's all. Number 10, listen to sweet music. Now, I don't know what I was thinking sweet meant, because this was at night and I was in bed. I was like, ooh, sweet music. So I wrote it down. I don't know what sweet music is. But whatever that is to you, maybe it could be Taylor Swift's Lover album, or some kind of Ariana Grande album, or whatever. Just listen to some fun music, honestly. That's what I should have written down. Number 11, get your nails done. So by saying get your nails done, you could probably do this the day before Valentine's Day so that your nails are pretty on Valentine's Day, which I need to do mine because they're not the best looking right now. That's a really fun thing to do. Number 12, give your dog or cat a special treat. Or if you don't have a dog or cat or pet, you can go to a animal shelter and just play with some dogs. I think this would be really fun because, you know, Valentine's Day is all about love, and you know, you love your pets. I have a dog, and she is the sweetest thing ever. She's my favorite dog in the whole world, and I love to spoil her so much. Like, she's precious. She's very spoiled. Number 13, call a friend or family member you haven't talked to in a while. Now, this could be a great-grandparent or a grandparent or someone that you don't usually get to see that often. Just call them and see how they're doing and tell them you love them because it's Valentine's Day. I think that even if it's just like 5 minutes, it's really a special thing. Or it could be if you moved somewhere and you have some really good friends that you can't really talk to all that much. Or you maybe moved schools and you don't see this one friend that you really enjoy hanging out with, but you haven't been able to. Just call them, especially even if it's like the day after Valentine's Day. It's still really special. Also, I don't know if I mentioned, I said 14 because February, because Valentine's Day is on February 14th, so I thought that would be like cool. Number 14, the last one, go on a spa date with your mother. Now this is really fun. A spa is so much fun, whether you do it with a friend, a grandma, your mom, your dad takes you, it doesn't matter. A spa is super fun, and I really enjoy spas. Especially getting like your mani and pedis done, it's like calming. Those are all the ideas that I had for you to do on Valentine's Day. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you liked this video and you like these kinds of videos, feel free to subscribe down below and turn on post notifications so you never miss one of my videos. My Instagram is at love.audreyanne, so if you feel like it, you can follow me on there as well. Thank you so, so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Bye!
And love is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you.